Today, I'm going to talk about how to keep specifically coyotes out of your coop. Coyotes are a special kind of predator that are after your chickens. They're very opportunistic. They have to hunt for every meal they get. They're not like a domestic animal where it's like, oh, there's a bowl of food and water right over there waiting for me. It's like they're always on the look. They have to be. That's just the way they are. That's the way they live. So we can't hold that against them. And they have a great sense of smell. I notice animals can smell from far away. They just catch a whiff and they know it's there. So we have to realize that when we're thinking about building our coop or reinforcing our coop to keep the coyotes out. The second thing we have to realize is they are going to be persistent. They have to be. They need to eat every day, so they're persistent for their whole life because that's just, they spend their whole life hunting basically to feed themselves and maybe laying around a little bit to relax, and then it's up again and out hunting they go. Once they know where a coop is, and like I said, they have a great sense of smell, they are gonna go check that every single day. It's like us going back to the grocery store week after week after week. I mean, they do the same thing to the coop. Once they know it's there, they're gonna come back just to see if anything's changed, if there's an opportunity, and you know, depending on how hungry they are, will determine how hard they try to get in your coop. But you can resist them, and I'm gonna tell you how. Okay, so the next thing we're gonna talk about is why the coop matters. The size of the coop and the coop material, what you build it out of. So picture your chickens in the hen house sleeping at night, because they sleep in the hen house on the roost at night, and picture one the size of a dog house. So they're like in there, they're like huddled in there, like trying to sleep, but you know, they're kind of nervous birds, so they're like, oh. And then your coop is so small, so the coyote is right there. Right there is the roof. It's like an The coyote knows the chicken's right in there, and the chicken's sitting there like, oh, he's right there. And it's like, it's just not a good situation. But if you picture a coop the size of mine, Chicken Town, and the hen house is 10 by 10, and it's tall so a person can walk in there. So my chickens are in there, and there's room. And if there's a, you know, one of the predators, which are lurking around, which they do, they'll get up on the roof and they'll come around here, they'll check the crack, see if they can fit in the crack there, and you know, they do a thorough investigation, believe me. But my chickens are in there and they're kind of like, haha, you're out there. They feel safer, and they're not like just sitting right there with the wall right next to them and the thing trying to eat them. It makes a difference, because when that coyote knows there's just, you know, 6 inches of space between it and the chicken, it is going to try harder. The second thing is material. You got to think of the Three Little Pigs story, where one builds his house out of bricks and the other is, you know, out of straw and whatever the story is. It's like, you got to think like that, and your house has to be built out of, not literally bricks, but it's got to be built good. I like to use these farm planks. They're thick. They're 1 inch thick, and they're like, you know, I think they're 6 inches wide. They're very sturdy. When you screw those on, I don't nail them on because over time they can work loose. If you screw those on, there's nothing can get in there. Coyotes can't dig, chew, or break their way in there. So now I want to talk about the roof. Recently, Joe Rogan talked about the coyotes chewing through his shingle roof. So I don't know if those are asphalt shingles or wood shingles, but I mean, if your chickens are in there and this animal's hungry, it's gonna, and it feels like it could get in there, it's gonna be digging around a little. And if it's like, oh, it's kind of weak, it's gonna keep at it because, you know, they have confidence in their ability. So it's gonna keep trying. The key is right here, metal roof. Now this is used secondhand metal, but it's awesome to have a metal roof because nothing's gonna be able to chew through that. And a lot of times once they get up there and it makes so much noise, even that just scares them, because they'll jump up there and it'll just be so noisy. They're kind of like, yikes, you know, because they want to creep around and get stuff. So that's another reason the metal works really good, is because it's kind of noisy when something jumps up there, you know, it's blew their cover, so to speak. So that works really, really good. So I highly recommend the metal roof on your chicken coop, hen house. I have a really big run and my run's pretty open here, and anything could jump right in here. But I have a fantastic farm dogs. I have Lincoln over there on the ground, he's eating. And then believe it or not, I have this little Chihuahua right there, and he is a little scrapper. That is a little bad boy. He will chase anything out into those woods in the pitch dark. He's just after it. They're just like tough little scrappy dogs, and that does make them more self-confident and more aggressive when they're trying to protect the farm. Just so you know the difference. Like a couch potato dog is like yawning, like, oh, where's my next treat? It's like, you know, it's like coyote. What's a coyote? You know, it doesn't even know really that it's like an enemy of the farm. So it's just gonna be like, yeah, whatever. You have to build according to your situation. So depending on what predators you have coming around. If I had coyotes coming around, I think my dogs would chase them off. But nevertheless, if I didn't have the dogs, I would build a run that has a wire floor, wire bottom, and then I would dump sand in there so they can still take a dust bath and stuff. But that would be good, strong wire that nothing could get through there. And then for the ultimate measure, if you're still having trouble, is you can put electric fence around your coop. So it would be completely enclosed with wire. Nothing could jump over and nothing could dig underneath it either. And then the little chickens would be happy and safe in there and cock-a-doodle-doo. There you go, nice big sandy floor. They pick and scratch, they're very happy. I just throw the food in here. I do have a feeder in my coop over here, but the funny thing is they like don't even eat out of it. Just their natural instinct is that they want to go over there and pick and scratch and get the stuff off the ground. They don't really want to eat out of the feeder. We're all natural over here. I built them a little ladder to go up to the roost. Yeah, here's a double roost. You have to make sure there's plenty of room on the roost. And then of course over here I have my nest boxes. I just cleaned these, and there's a little squabble going on between the guinea hen and the Americana chicken, and they break the eggs. The guinea breaks the chicken eggs because she's like mean and jealous that she's laying her eggs in there. The two girls battling over their two-time and man, and then they'll break each other's eggs. But no big deal, like whatever, that happens. So I just have to clean that nest box out. So that's my advice if you're having problems with coyotes getting into your coop. And if you do these few things, I think you'll have great success and your chickens will be happy and safe.